Praise the Lord. Amen. It's good to see each and every one of you here in the house of the Lord this afternoon. Amen. Everyone say it's hot. Amen. Someone said they like the heat. I'm telling you. I'm ready for fall. And it can't get here fast enough, let me tell you. Amen. We're blessed today. And even though it's hot and 900 degrees and I'm melting every time I go outside, the Lord is still good. Amen. Amen. God is good to us. I'm blessed today. You know, even in the middle of my circumstances, God is still worthy. Amen. Even in when I'm struggling and I'm in the middle of a trial, my God is still worthy. Amen. Amen. There's not anything that He can do or that I can do to take away how worthy He is. Amen. He's always faithful. He never leaves us and forsake us. Amen. What a promise today. Amen. He's good to us. Amen. Can we give the Lord some praise in this place? And thank Him for His goodness today. Amen. 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 I want to go to the Lord in prayer. Let's remember all of our junior campers. Amen. They're having a wonderful time up there, and just pray that God moves upon all them childrens. Amen. There's a bunch of them there today and through Friday. Amen. My boy's up there. Avery's his first time going to camp, and they're up there, and I think he's just having a good old time. And amen. They said Avery's just a class clown, and I don't see him as a class clown, but you get him away from his parents, he's a class clown, I guess. I don't know. Amen. I just pray that God just blesses him and all the little ones that win, especially my boy. He really needs the Lord at all times. Amen. And all of our Sunday school class. We're definitely blessed with a great Sunday school class. And amen. Let's just continue to pray for them. Let them have a good time. Pastor and them are gone. He had to go clean today, and he had to go back and forth. He's really busy. So let's just pray for him. Amen. That God has just blessed them and their rest. Amen. Everyone needs rest. Let's just pray for their rest. Amen. Any unspoken requests? Amen. Amen. Let's just go to the Lord in prayer. Lord, we love you. We're thankful to be in your house today, God. We're thankful to feel your presence this afternoon. And Lord, we just ask that you move upon every need, every situation, God, every hand that was raised in this place. Lord, you are forever faithful, God. You're not a liar today. And Lord, you say you'll never leave us and forsake us, God. You'll say you'll go with us until the end of the world. And therefore, we're thankful. We're thankful, God, for your goodness and your faithfulness. Lord, we're thankful today that you lend an ear to us, God, that you hear our cries. Lord, as you pay attention to us today, Lord, every need, God, every hand that was lifted up, Lord, minister to them, minister to our young children, Lord, all of our campers that they're up there having a great time. Lord, I just pray you fill them with the Holy Ghost, fill them with purpose, amen. Just fill them with confidence today, move upon them today in the name of Jesus. Lord, we give you the praise and the honor today in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Let's worship the Lord.
I'm forgiven because you were forsaken. I'm accepted, you were condemned. I'm alive and well, your spirit is within me because you died and rose again. That you, my King, would die for me. Amazing love, I know it's true, and it's my joy to honor you in all I do. I honor you. I'm forgiven. You were condemned, and I'm alive and well. Your spirit is within me because you died and rose again. Thank you, Jesus. Amazing love, how can it be my joy to honor you in all I do. Lord, I honor you. You are my King. Jesus, you are my King. You
place. Amen. You know, if there's one place that he should be welcome, honored, and exalted, it's in the house of the Lord. Amen. We're blessed today to be able to have church. We're blessed to be able to be in his presence. Amen. We are a blessed people today. Amen. Amen. If our ushers will get ready, amen, we'll take up our tithes and offering. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. The Lord is good. Amen. Just repeat this with me. Upon the authority of your word, I have given and it shall be given to me, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. I am a tither. I bring my tithe today into your storehouse. Therefore, the enemy is rebuked. The curse is broken. I live under an open heaven. You pour out upon me such a blessing that there is not room to receive it. We receive jobs and better jobs, raises and bonuses, sales and commissions, benefits and settlements, estates and inheritance, interest and income, rebates and returns, checks in the mail, gifts and surprises, bills paid off, debts demolished, and royalties received. My whole family saved and walking with God in perfect health and abundance to walk in divine favor and blessings. I'm blessed going in and I'm blessed going out, and all that I do will prosper in Jesus' name. Amen. Can we give the Lord a hand clap of praise?
You give life, you are love. You bring light to the darkness. You give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord. You give life, you are love. You bring light to the darkness. You give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise. Pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise. Pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise to you only, Lord. Great are you, Lord. are love. You bring light to the darkness. You give hope. You restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise, pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise, pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs.
He's so good to us. Amen. You know, sometimes God will take you through, you know, a circumstance, a trial, you know, to get you back to where you need to be, right? Amen. But that's one of the many reasons why I worship Him today. Amen. Because so many times, Brother Tim, we slip and we fall, and you know, we may not be as on fire as God as we once was, or you know, we may still be on fire, whatever the case may be, but I'm thankful that God never gives up on us. Amen, amen. No, we don't like the fire. Amen, but I'm sure glad that He gives it to us. Amen, amen. It's a blessing to be in the house of the Lord. Amen. And he does deserve all the glory and the honor today. Amen. Because there's not a single one of us in here tonight that deserve to be here. Amen. It's the fact that he found us. Amen. That he chose you and he chose me. Amen. Everyone look at their neighbor and say, God chose you. Amen. Amen. You did not choose yourself. Amen. I didn't find Jesus. I can tell you that right now. When I came to this, I did not find him, but he come finding me. I'm thankful for him tonight. Amen. Amen. In Matthew 4 and 10, it kind of goes along with this song here. It says, and then Jesus said unto him, go away, Satan, for it is written, and forever remains written, you shall worship the Lord your God and serve him only. Amen. Amen. Only the Lord. I'm thankful that I know who he is today. Amen. No matter what the world may say, no matter what the enemy says, I know who he truly is. Amen. I know who he is because of what he's done for me. Amen. I'm blessed today to know that Jesus Christ is my Lord and Savior. Amen. I'm blessed to know that he saved me from my mess. Amen. And has given me an opportunity to be able to make heaven my home. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. And I want to talk to you for a little bit tonight. It's just about worship. Amen. Worship. Could you pray with me? Lord, we love you. We're thankful to be in your presence, God. We're thankful for your goodness and your mercy today. Lord, we just ask that you bless this service, God. I ask you to just fix this broken vessel just one more time for your glory. Lord, let your words flow today, God. Let it touch hearts and minds, God. Let it move upon our hearts today, God. And let it resonate inside of us, Lord. We just ask that you bless this service, bless the people in the name of Jesus. Everybody say in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated. Amen. Amen. Church, we are truly blessed. And when we think about this crazy world we're living in right now, amen, we don't really know what's going to happen. I mean, I don't know how high gas prices are going to get, but amen. It's just an uncertain world right now. Amen. We don't know what's going to be around the corner. We don't know what's going to happen. I mean, this is probably the most uncertain times that we have lived in. Amen. At any given moment, anything can happen. I don't believe that we would be surprised of what would happen because of the times that we're living in. But, amen. But one thing that never changes, and that's him. Amen. No matter how corrupt this world gets, or no matter how far the world gets away from him, amen, the United States of America, one thing will still remain the same, that Jesus still sits on the throne. Amen. And no matter what you face or what I face or what we go through together as a church, God is still on the throne. Amen. And what a wonderful thing that we have in him. Amen. That he is still there and he will continue to be there. And that is one of the reasons why I worship him. Amen. That no matter what I go through or what I face, Jesus is still there. Amen. He has an ear that is always listening for me. He's always listening for my cry. He's always listening for my fasting and my worship. He's always listening to me and to you tonight. Amen. Don't ever think that God does not hear you. Amen. Because he does. That's one thing you can rest assured today, that Jesus is still there. Amen. There are many times in my life, Brother Bruce, that I've realized that God has had his hand upon my life. Amen. From where I came from to where I am now is a miracle. Amen. And a testimony. And the many times that he has protected me in my life, as far as if I didn't have the hand of God in my life, that I may not be here today because of an accident or because of drugs or whatever the case may be. Amen. It's in those moments that I realize how great he truly is and how wonderful he is. Amen. And that's, he deserves deserves my worship because of it, amen. That God would take time out for you and take time out for me, amen. That is enough right there that I can give him everything that I got. The fact that he allowed us to have a chance for salvation, amen, allowed us to have an opportunity to make heaven our home, amen. That's enough right there to allow us to shout and to worship him with everything we got, because he's saving us from a devil's hell, amen. He's given us an opportunity for eternal life. Amen. But this world, the things we face, amen. If I could be transparent with you, it's easy to drift away. Not that I'm not living for the Lord, but not that I'm studying or praying as fervently as I used to. Does anybody know what I'm talking about today? Amen. Anybody ever been in a rut? Amen. But I want to talk about worship tonight. In John 4 and 23 through 24, very familiar scripture, it says, "But the hour cometh and now is when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth, for the Father seeketh such to worship him." Amen. God seeks your worship. Amen. When you lift up your hands and you magnify him and you start placing him on that throne where he belongs, amen, God seeks it. He yearns for your praise. He yearns for that heartfelt worship, amen. He yearns for it. It is precious to his ears, amen. And I believe that God waits for it every time we open our mouths. 24 says, "God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth." Amen. Together, the word spirit and truth means that real worship comes from within the heart, amen, and is based upon our understanding. Amen. I'm thankful for the word of God this evening, though, that I know who he is, and I know what he's done for me. I know how many times he has healed my body. I know what he's done in my family. I've watched him touch my wife on numerous occasions, amen. I am thankful and I understand truly today who he is. He is my Savior. He is my King of Kings. He is the Lord of Lords in my life. Amen. And I thank him for it today. Amen. So many times we come to the church and we go through the motions. Amen. And I've been there and I've done that. But true worship should engage the heart. Amen. True worship ought to be from the heart, heartfelt. God, I thank you. Lord, I thank you for breath. Lord, I thank you for a job. Lord, I thank you for the things that you have given me. Lord, I'm thankful for the Holy Ghost this morning. Lord, I'm thankful, God, that you have baptized in the name of the Holy Ghost. Lord, I'm thankful for what you've done in my life, God. I've been filled with the Holy Ghost and baptized in Jesus' name. Amen. True word, truth without emotion or truth without the heart produces non-effective worship. Amen. I'm thankful today that God has touched this broken heart of mine, that God has moved upon this heart in my life. Amen. I'm thankful for that today. On the other hand, emotion without understanding produces chaos. Amen. Let me tell you today, I don't want to just be a person who worships without understanding why I worship, but just because I worship him because I know who he is today and what he's done for me. God has done so much for me not to worship him. And guess what? I understand that this evening. Amen. I understand what he's done for me. I understand where he's brought me from. I believe there is a multitude of testimonies in here about how good God is and what he has done for you. I bet you we can go on all night and all week about the things that God has done in this place. Amen. The healings, the miracles, the salvation that's in this place. Amen. We can go on and on. And we're not standing here tonight, or we're not in this building tonight and not understanding what God has done. We all know what he has done. Amen. We know how good he's been to us. We know how trustworthy he's been to us. We know how faithful he has been to us. And I'm thankful for that this evening. Can we give the Lord some praise in this place? Amen. Can we just thank him because he is good to us and he's always faithful today? Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen, amen. I'm not getting in trouble. Praise the Lord. Amen. 2 Samuel 6 and 14. says, "And David danced before the Lord with all of his might, and David was girded with the linen ephod." Amen. David was a king of Israel. Israel was a dominant nation in that part of the world during his lifetime. David was a military mastermind, amen. David was very wise. I don't believe you can get much by David. He was very wise. He knew exactly what God has intended him to do. He knew exactly what to do as a king. In fact, he was the father of Solomon, who was known as the wisest king in the world. David was someone to pay attention to. David was a very smart guy. David had it all going up here, but he also had it in here. Amen. As smart and as brilliant as David was, David loved the Lord with all of his what? His heart. Amen. He loved him with everything that he has. That's why in 2 Samuel 6 and 14, we find David dancing before the Lord with all of his might. Amen. It didn't matter who saw him. It didn't matter how many people didn't like it. It didn't matter what was happening around him. God has done too much for David for him to miss out on a blessing. God has been too good for him not to bless the Lord. God has done so much for me. Amen. If you love to worship and are not worshiping, that is not truth. If you know how to worship and are hindered by what people may think of you, that is not truth. Truth worships because it has determined to put God before and above anything else in this world. Amen. When I realize how good God is, amen, I don't care what you think I look like. I don't care what you think I've been through. I know what God has done for me. I know where God has brought me from. Amen. And it doesn't matter what you say or what the world says. God is still worthy to be praised. Amen. He is too good not to worship. He's been too good not to praise. Hallelujah. Amen. God is good to us. Amen. If we are ashamed, we will never enter into true worship. Amen. If I'm worried about what Sister Kathy thinks of me, amen, I will never make it into worship like I need to. If I worry about what Brother Bruce thinks of me, don't say it, bro. Amen. I will never enter into that true worship. Amen. It's when I get up here and I block out the things of this world and I can put my mind upon Him, amen, that I can enter into that true worship. If we are embarrassed of who we are, amen, we will never be able to enter into true worship. Amen. I love what I am and I love what I stand for. Amen. I love the truth that we have. Amen. I love the oneness. And I'm blessed to be able to be baptized in the name of Jesus. Amen. I'm so blessed. I've been filled with the Holy Ghost. Amen. And I am not ashamed of it. Amen. I will tell everyone about the Holy Ghost and I will tell them how to receive it. Amen. We must not be embarrassed about what we have. Amen. But if we are embarrassed, we will never enter that true worship. Amen. True worship requires sincerity. It requires genuineness. It requires honesty. True worship doesn't care who is watching. True worship isn't worried about what other people think. True worship is directed to God and isn't concerned about anybody else at that moment, because true worship is not just connected at the heart, but it's also connected in the mind. The heart knows what the head needs and the head knows what the heart needs. Amen. I'm thankful today for spirit and truth. I'm thankful today for understanding who He is and what He's done. Understand this tonight. True worship touches the heart of God. True worship is attractive to people who are hurting and who need Him. Hear that. True worship is attractive to people who are hurting and who need Him. Amen. There's just something about my wife's worship. Amen. When she gets to that point, I mean, it just melts my heart. Amen. Because I can see what God is doing in our life, and I've seen what God has done in our life. I know the testimonies. I've been through part of them. Amen. I know how good God has been. So when I see her weeping and crying and speaking in tongues, amen, it's just not affecting her, but it's working on this old heart of mine too. Because I remember when I see her crying, I can see God's miracle working power in her life, and how much she loves him because of how good he has been. True worship invites the presence of God. Amen. There is nothing that will get the presence of God in here quicker than worship. Amen. True worship invokes the power and the anointing of God and his Holy Spirit. If you have a need in your life today, guess what you begin with? His worship. Amen. You begin to worship him. You already know the truth. You already know that God can heal. The word says, by his stripes you are healed. You know that God can just speak a word and he can touch your body. Amen. You know God can do it in an instant. Amen. He did it as people walked by the shadows. Amen. He could heal. Amen. He took the mud and wiped it in their eyes, and he healed the blind. I mean, there is nothing that God cannot do, and we understand that today, right? But it's the worship that we must get. It's the worship that we must get into that realm of the supernatural. Amen. When we begin to worship, we create an atmosphere. And when we begin to lift up the name of Jesus, we allow his presence to dwell with us. Amen. We want the power of God in our services at this church. And we have been. I mean, I've been seeing God do some great things. Amen. Look around, church. Maybe not tonight. I'm kidding. There's a lot of miracles here tonight. I'm just saying, look around to see what God has done. Look at our youth group. Look at our Sunday school. Look at the people that's been filled with the Holy Ghost. Amen. Look at the people that have been coming. God has been working. Amen. And as long as we keep his presence in this building, amen, God will continue to work. We want the anointing of his Spirit to incorporate our worship here. We are praying, God, send down your Spirit, when we know that the anointing of his Spirit, without the anointing of his Spirit, we are nothing. Amen. We are not interested in being a church that does not desperately seek after the anointing of God's Spirit. Amen. I don't care how talented you are today. There is nothing more precious than an anointed singer. Amen. There is nothing more precious than an anointed speaker. Amen. There's something about the anointing that when it flows, amen, you just love what you feel. Amen. If Jesus doesn't show up, are we really having church? Are we really here to have church if we don't feel his presence? Amen. It's in his presence that he heals. He saves, he delivers, he sets free. Amen. I can't do any of these things. Amen. And neither can you. We need him in our presence. Amen. We need him to move within our services. Without that happening, we're just coming here to hear a band and a lecture. Amen. But when his anointing is here, we are having church. Amen. There is a difference, church, when the anointing is in this house. Amen, amen. Hallelujah. There may be a few of you here this evening who need delivered today, and a few words from this preacher will not allow that to happen. Amen. I can say everything that I can. I can read the Bible. It doesn't make me anything, but it's his Spirit that we need in his place. We need the power of God. We need the presence of God. We need the anointing of his Spirit in our services that only happens when we worship him. Amen. I don't know about you, but I need to feel his presence today. Amen. How many of you have a situation in your life right now? Amen. We need his presence. Amen. It's in his presence that God works the miraculous. It's when he shows up that anything can take place. Amen. I long for him to come into this place and fill every one of us with his Spirit again.
And I'm talking about a refreshing of the Holy Ghost. I long for Him the day that the first Pentecostal church can be described as a place where the presence and the power of God is felt in every service. Amen. Brother Bruce, He inhabits the praises of His people. Amen. So, worship. Amen. I can stand here today and I can list off things that God has done for me. But worship should be without reservation. It should be without shame. It should be without worry about what people think. But we are here to worship His name, right? We're here to glorify the name. We're here to worship, to invite His presence into this service. We're here to worship, to allow His presence and His power to fill this room. Amen. So why do we worship? With determination, with attitude. Amen. Of Jesus Christ, without hesitation, with certainty, with conviction, with an expectation of the miraculous. Can I ask you today, when was the last time you came into this service with an expectation of leaving with a blessing? I mean, was the last time that you came into this place and said, God, I'm leaving here with a miracle? When was the last time you came into this house and said, God, I need an answer. Lord, I need You to show me, God, what direction I need to go. God, I need You to move in my life. And you left with your answer. Amen. Psalms 150, 1 through 6, it says, praise ye the Lord. Praise God in His sanctuary. Praise Him in the firmament of His power. Praise Him for His mighty acts. Praise Him according to His excellent greatness. Praise Him in the sound of a trumpet. Praise Him with a psaltery and harp. Praise Him with a tremble and dance. Praise Him with the stringed instruments and organs. Praise Him upon the loud cymbals, and praise Him upon the loud sounding cymbals. Let everything that have breath praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. Amen. Brother Bruce, you did great today, man. He had to turn the drums around. If I went over there and tried to play it, I'd be all crossed backwards. Amen. He's a left-handed drummer, so amen. I'm just glad he was able to play comfortably, and he did really good. Amen. Just because you don't play an instrument doesn't mean that you can't praise Him, though. I mean, just because you don't stand up here or sing doesn't mean you can't stand out there and sing. I mean, just because you don't stand up here and preach doesn't mean that you can't stand out there and worship Him. Amen. Just because you don't hold a position doesn't mean that we can't praise Him. Just because things ain't going right in life doesn't mean that we can't praise Him. Just because you're in a valley, it doesn't mean that you can't praise Him. Amen. If everything that has breath, praise ye the Lord. Amen, amen. Paul and Silas, amen, Acts 16, 20 through 2 through 26 says, and the multitude rose up against them, and the magistrates rent off their clothes and commanded to beat them. And when they laid many stripes upon them, they cast them into prison, charging the jailer to keep them safely, who, having received such charge, thrust them into the inner prison and made their feet fast in the stocks. And at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God, and the prisoners heard them. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundations of the prison were shaken, and immediately all the doors were open and everyone's bands were loosed. Amen. Even if you think that you are bound in a way that you may never get out of, amen, even if you think the enemy has got you down so far, you will always have an ability to praise. I mean, Paul and Silas were in as deep as they can go. Their hands and their feet were locked up. They weren't able to run. They weren't able to do any flips or holy rolling, whatever you want to call it. But they still had a praise inside of them. They knew something, that if I could just praise Him, if we can just lift up the name of Jesus, He will deliver us today. And that's exactly what happened. If you are breathing here today, and you both have a right and an obligation to worship Him. If you are not dead today, you have an opportunity to be a worshiper in this house. Amen. How many of you are thankful that God is good to us? Amen. There are many things. There are many things that the enemy can take away. The devil can take away your family. He can take away your house. He can take away your car, your job. He can inflict pain upon your body. But there's one thing he cannot take away, and that is your praise. Amen. You will always have a worship. You will always have a song. You will always have a praise. Amen. The devil can't stop your voice. In the name of Jesus. The Bible talks about worship in many ways. Dancing, clapping, singing, shouting. Amen. Acts 4:24 says they lifted up their voice with one accord. Amen. There's something about a group of church people, a body of people together, magnifying the name of Jesus. Amen. If everyone in this house would stand to their feet and start exalting the name of the Lord, there ain't no telling what could happen in this place. Psalms 134:2 says, lift up your hands in the sanctuary and bless the Lord. Psalms 98:4 says, make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all the earth. Make a loud noise and rejoice and sing praises. 2 Samuel 6:5 says, and the house of Israel played before the Lord and on all manner of instruments. Psalms 47:1 says, oh, clap your hands, all ye people. Shout unto God with a voice of triumph. Amen. I believe that's a key right there. That verse right there will let you know how to get out of your trials. Amen. It doesn't say just shout. Amen. It doesn't just say raise your voice. Amen. But it says shout unto God with a voice of triumph. With victory, amen. There's got to be some faith left inside of us. There's got to be something inside of us. Says God, He's going to bring me through it. A voice of triumph. Psalms 150:4 says, praise Him with a tremble and dance. Praise Him with the stringed instruments and organs. Amen. Praising God and worshiping God is something that is found throughout the Scriptures. Amen. Amen. In fact, worship over and over again is found to be a weapon used by God's people to defeat the works of the enemy. Amen. I'll say that again. Worship is used as a weapon by God's people to defeat the works of the enemies. 2 Chronicles 20:15, it says, and he said, hearken ye all Judah, all ye inhabitants of Judah, and thou King Jehoshaphat, thus saith the Lord unto you, be not afraid or dismayed by reason of this great multitude, for the battle is not yours, but it is God's. Amen. That's one thing we have to realize, what is ours and what is His. Amen. I'm thankful today that God will fight our battles. Continue on. It says, tomorrow go ye down against them. Behold, they come up by the cliff of Ziz, and ye shall find them at the end of the brook before the wilderness of Jerel. Ye shall not need to fight this battle. Set yourself, stand ye still, and see the salvation of the Lord with you, O Judah and Jerusalem. Fear not, nor be dismayed. Tomorrow and go out against them, for the Lord be with you. Amen. I'm so thankful that God fights your battles. Continuing, it says, and Jehoshaphat bowed his head with his face to the ground, and all Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem fell before the Lord, worshiping the Lord, and the Levites and the children of the Kohathites and the children of the Korahites stood up to praise the Lord God of Israel with a loud voice on high. And they rose early in the morning and went forth to the wilderness of Tekoa. And they went forth, and Jehoshaphat stood and said, hear me, O Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem, believe in the Lord your God, so shall ye be established. Believe his prophets, so shall ye prosper. And when he had consulted them, I'm almost there, when he had consulted with the people, he appointed singers unto the Lord that should praise the beauty of holiness. And they went out before the army. They went out before the army. Amen. They went out before the army and to say, praise the Lord, for his mercy endureth forever. And when they began to sing and to praise, the Lord set ambushments against the children of Ammon, Moab, and Mount Seir, which were come against Judah, and they were smitten. Amen. Let me tell you today, there is power in your worship and your praise. Amen. The Bible says that the worshipers went before the battle. Amen. There's so many times that we get ahead of ourselves. Amen. If we would just come and we start praising and we start magnifying, amen, and don't fight it ourselves, but allow the Lord to fight our battles. And all we got to do is magnify Him. And the Bible says that the enemy was smitten because of the Lord. There is just something powerful about worship once you understand the why and the who you are worshiping. There is something powerful when you understand that God is for you and He fights your battle, and all you have to do is praise Him. You have a choice today. You can choose to sit and stay in your situation, or you can praise your way out of it. Amen. You have a choice this evening. So what's it going to be tonight? Amen. Are we just going to sit as the world falls apart and as everything seems like God is losing control, which He's not, obviously, but everything going against Jerusalem, everything that's happening in our country. Amen. They're trying to take God out of everything. And here we are. We can choose to stay and just allow this to happen. Or you can choose to stay in your circumstances, your situations, or your trials. Or you can praise your way out of it. Amen. I'm closing tonight. In Psalms 149, it says, "Praise ye the Lord. Sing unto the Lord a new song, and His praise in the congregation of saints. Let Israel rejoice in Him that made him. Let the children of Zion be joyful in their king. Let them praise His name in a dance, and let them sing praises unto Him with a trembling harp. For the Lord has taken pleasure in His people. He will beautify the meek with salvation. Let the saints be joyful in glory. Let them sing aloud upon their beds. Let the high praises of God be in their mouth, and a two-edged sword in their hand, to execute vengeance upon the heathen and punishment upon the people, to bind their kings with chains and their nobles and with fetters of iron, to execute upon the judgment written, this honor have all His saints. Praise ye the Lord." Amen. There's just something about worship. Amen. When you get into the realm of worship, it separates you. Amen. From what's happening. I don't compare to fishing. I love to fish, okay? So when I go fishing, that's my break from reality. I'm out there, I'm with nature, I'm just relaxing, and I can really just relax. That's my relaxing spot. Amen. But that's the way worship is. And I'm not comparing it to fishing. It's not even close. But it's something about when I get into His presence. Amen. When I feel the presence of the Holy Ghost, when I feel His loving arms wrap around me, when I can feel the goosebumps start to take over, amen, it separates me from the world. Amen. It separates me from reality, where I can just be in His presence and just allow God to do what He does. Amen. And work upon my life. It's only in His presence that I can be free. Amen. I feel like I'm liberated in His presence. Amen. Worship. Worship is the key to a Christian's life. And of course, prayer. But worship, God inhabits it. He seeks it. He wants to hear it from you. Amen. So let us find a place as we stand. Amen. How many have a thankful heart tonight? I do. But also, how many people are struggling? I've seen a lot of hands already. Amen. We don't have to stay there. We can worship and let God take care of it. Amen. Let us find a place to pray and worship tonight. In Jesus' name.
This offering that I bring, humbly I fall on my knees to to proclaim your everything. My life's nothing without you. Take my hand and lead me through. You are my sustaining love. Claim your everything. My life's nothing without you. Take my hand and lead me through. You are my sustaining love.
I'm not ashamed.
be you. With all I am, I'm worshiping you. Bowing down, spirit and truth. With lifted hands, I'm worshiping you.
Thankful for his presence. He's good to us, church. Amen. We'll never go a day without remembering what the Lord has done. Amen. So good to us. Amen. Remember this weekend. Tomorrow there's a recovery, right, Brother Bruce? Recovery tomorrow. He's back there. Amen. Don't forget that. This weekend service, just remember that. Also, Sister Dorothy wanted me to announce, everyone say VBS.
Yes.
They're not very excited about it. This Saturday and every Saturday after it, I think the times may vary, but this Saturday at 10, I know there's a men's outing, but any of the women that want to come and help, she's going to start work days. Which there's a lot that goes into these, and most of you know, but if you're new here, there's a bunch that goes into our Vacation Bible School. So she can use all the help that she can get this Saturday at 10, correct? 10 o'clock, yes. And also, that reminds me, men, we're having our outing this Saturday, so you can bring your wives and drop them off, and we'll be leaving here at 10. Amen. We're going to go to the Amadon. It's going to be a time of just hanging out with God's beautiful creation. If you've never been up there, it's a beautiful place. It's a pretty good ways away. It's about an hour away, but it's very pretty. It's neat. They call it Pink Rock. It's all this granite, and it's just a shut-in. It's a real nice place. Anyways, this Saturday, I think we're leaving at 10. Amen. All the men that want to go, just be here, and we'll head out. Amen. Is there any other announcements that I can think of? Brother Neiswanger's preaching the 18th. So he'll be here for that. Amen. That's it. Let us stand. Amen. Lord, we love you. We're thankful for this day. Thankful for your presence we felt in this place. Lord, we just ask that you go with us the rest of this week. Keep your hand upon us. Lord, move upon our lives, God. We're forever thankful for the things you have done for us. God, let us be a light. Let us be a true testament of what you've done. God, let us shine bright for you this week. God, let us come back Sunday expecting great things. In the name of Jesus, amen, amen. You're dismissed.